about it than it is when your emotions start getting into it, because we naturally, our will naturally flow from our emotions. This dynamic faith that James is talking about is the kind of faith that think about how much God can do so much that we start feeling that thing. Thinking about how much God said he was going to do till we start feeling that thing. Thinking about God who can save anybody so much that we start going out telling everybody. A faith that believe God can heal so much that it ain't just in our head. We going to the hospital to lay hands on some sick folk. That's the kind of faith that he's talking about in this text today. Abraham, being not weak in faith, considered not his own body now dead, when he was about 100 years old, neither yet the deadness of Sarah's womb. His faith was so strong in God that he ain't even think about the fact he shouldn't be having a child. He didn't even think about the fact that he was too old, that his wife never had a child. His faith was strong. So the question, beloved, is this. How do we get this type of strong faith? How do we get it? Anybody really want to just believe God for anything? The gift of faith is a powerful gift to have. The person that just believes God, number one, keeps God happy all the time. For without faith, it's impossible to please God. And a person that believes God causes God to work on his behalf. But the key is this. We can't just believe God for stuff that God never said he was going to do. You can't believe God for that man to be your husband, and you already know he's somebody else's husband. Keep looking at me. Ain't nobody gonna know what I'm talking about. You can't believe God to kill your boss because you don't like your boss. God is only gonna do what he said he's gonna do. So you need to get in the word so you can know what God is saying and start seeking what God is saying, and then you'll see what God said he was gonna do. Listen here. Two chapters earlier in Mark chapter 9, the disciples are, watch this, they are praying. They are doing their best to try to cast a demon out of a little boy. And the Bible said they couldn't get the demon out the little boy, no matter how much they did. And so first glance of the text may cause us to think the reason they couldn't get the demon out of the boy is because they didn't have the power to do that. But previously, they was boasting to Jesus, saying, look, even the demons are subject to us in your name. We casting demons out. So they had the ability to cast demons out. There was something else going on here. This was a type of situation that required more faith than the previous situations that they had in their life. This was a type of situation that caused them to believe God in a way they haven't grown to believe God yet. And so Jesus comes, and the reason I know this, because they asked Jesus, why couldn't we cast them out? And Jesus said, because of your unbelief. And so he said, watch this. This kind can come by nothing but prayer and fasting. He's not talking about this kind of demon. He's talking about this kind of faith. He said it's because of your unbelief you couldn't do this. And this type of belief can only come by prayer and fasting. Why this type of belief in God comes through prayer and fasting? Because prayer and fasting removes all of the things that causes us to doubt God. When we cut the TV off and we push away the food and all of the stuff that feed our flesh, and we start talking to God and spending time with God and knowing what type of God he is, then it increases how much we believe God and what we're trusting God to do. Jesus is saying you can't deal with these types of situations until you get your faith to another level. And your faith is not going to go to another level until you dig deeper in God, till you push the plate back, until you get on your knees, till you start praying and searching my word. This kind can come by nothing but prayer and fasting. But watch this. Before he cast the demon out of the boy, Mark 9, verse 23. Jesus said to the boy's father, if. See, if is a conditional clause. It means what you do on one side of it will be accomplished on the other side of it. So don't just take the promise if you don't meet the condition. He says, if you can believe, all things are possible to him who believes. But that ain't the part that makes me happy. The part that makes me happy is the man's response. The man said, Lord, I believe, but help my unbelief. Some of us believe, but we need God to help us with our unbelief. I got a little bit of belief, but I'm not sure I'm believing you're going to bring my cousin out of a coma. I got a little bit of belief, but I don't really have enough belief that you're going to heal me of this breast cancer. I got a little bit of belief that you can save somebody, but I don't believe that you can get my son out of these gangs. I got a little bit of belief, but Lord, help my unbelief. So this kind of faith, and I'm done, this kind of faith comes by prayer and by fasting. God want to do some great, grand things in this Maywood community, in this church, in this congregation. But he's looking for somebody that's going to believe him. He's looking for somebody who faith.